Nilitanyena tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Namam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through Srimad Bhagavatam, fifth canto, and this week we're on chapter 26, which is Sukadev Goswami's description of the hellish planets.
我们学习圣典波迦瓦坛第五篇，这一周我们要学习的是第26章 Sukadeva Goswami 将为我们描述对地狱星球的描述。
Sukadeva Goswami has been describing all the different planets in the universe, and he explained the structure of the universe and how the different planets are situated.
Sukadeva Goswami 为我们描述了整个宇宙的构造，那些星球到底居住在什么地方？
So he described the Earth is about number 7 in the level of the planets coming from the higher planets. It comes, the Earth is in the middle, number 7. There's 7 above and 7 below.
Sukadeva Goswami 给我们描述到地球是在从上到下数的第七个星球，它是处于中间的部分，七个在上面，七个在下面。
So he described about the subterranean heavenly planets where the demons live.
之前他还描述到地下的天堂星球，地下天堂星球那里居住着的一些恶魔。
And then we heard about planets where Lord Vamanadev stays with Bali Maharaj.
我们还听到了主Vamanadeva和Bali Maharaj所居住的那个星球。
And we heard about also Anantashesha, how he's at the bottom of the universe and he holds the universe is on his hoods like a mustard seed.
我们还听到了主阿兰达的荣耀，他如何在这个宇宙的底部用他的头顶起这个宇宙，就像一粒芥末籽一样顶起这个宇宙。
And now we're hearing about the hellish planets, which are situated between the Garbhadak Ocean and Patala Loka.
现在我们将要听地狱星球的描述，它居住在帕塔拉卢卡和帕塔卢卡和这个和这个噶尔波达山羊之间的地方。
Yeah, the hellish planets are situated just above the Garbhadak Ocean.
地狱星球就只是在波达山羊之上面一点点的地方。
So Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami, he asked him, why are the living entities put into different material situations?
Parikshit Maharaj 向 Sukadeva Goswami 询问道，为什么这些生物被投入到不同的物质情况之中呢？
So obviously the answer is that sinful people, they're put into the hellish planets, and the pious people, they're put into the heavenly planets.
很显然对这个问题的一般的描述就是，罪恶的人他被投入到地狱星球之中。 而虔诚的人他会进入到天堂星球之中。
So different people get different kinds of body features and bodily conditions due to their past activities.
因此不同的人根据他们过去不同的活动被置于不同的躯体以及不同的地方。
Sukadeva Goswami explains there are three different kinds of activities.
Sukadeva Goswami 给我描述到有三种不同类型的活动。
There's the mode of goodness, the mode of passion, and the mode of ignorance.
处在善良形态的活动、激情属性下的活动，以及处于愚昧形态之中的活动。
So people in the mode of goodness, they're happy and they're religious.
处在善良形态中的人，他们非常的快乐，而且非常虔诚，有宗教心。
And people in passion, they have a mixture of happiness and suffering.
在激情形态中的人，他们的快乐就是苦乐参半。
But people in the mode of ignorance, they're always unhappy, they're always suffering.
而在愚昧形态下被控制的、受影响的人，他们总是不快乐。
And people in the mode of ignorance, they live like animals.
在愚昧形态下影响下的人，他们像动物一样的在生活。
So by doing pious activities, one goes to the heavenly planets, and you can enjoy a long life there.
通过从事虔诚的活动，你可以去到天堂星球，在那里享受很长的生命。
And people who are impious,They go into the hellish planets, and they're in a mode of ignorance, so they're put into a very miserable condition of life.
而一个不虔诚、从事不虔诚活动的人，他会到地狱星球之中，在那里过上非常痛苦的生活。
There are different kinds of hellish conditions. Some people are mad, so they're not aware of about what kind of condition they're in.
有不同程度的这种愚昧形态的这种状况，有一些人是属于疯狂，他们不理解自己的这个状况。
So they don't get so much suffering. They're not put into too much.Of a hellish condition because they're crazy anyway.
因为他们非常的疯狂，他们痛苦的程度相对而言还比较轻。
But if somebody knows the difference between what's pious and what's impious, then he gets more suffering.
但是那些如果知道虔诚和不虔诚活动的这些活动的区别的人，他们会遭受非常严重的苦难。
But the person who gets the most suffering is the person who's an atheist, who is very sinful and ignorant, and he doesn't believe in anything.
而最遭受的苦难最多的是那些处于无神论。非常不虔诚的这些人，他们在地狱的生活是最恶劣的。
So every living entity has been put into all different conditions, but been into many different conditions in the hellish planets since time immemorial, since the beginning of time.
从无可追忆的时间起，这些生物就被投入到各种不同的地狱星球之中。
So Maharaj Parikshit wants to know, he said, are these hellish regions, are these outside the universe, or are they within the universe, or are they in different places on this planet?
Maharaj Parikshit, 他想知道这些地狱的星球，它是在这个宇宙之外呢，还是在这个宇宙之内，处于不同的地方呢？
So Sukadeva Goswami explains, these hellish planets,They're in the space between the above the hellish planets are the three worlds, and below is the Garbhodak ocean. So in that space between, that's where the hellish planets are.
Shukadeva Goswami 描述到这个，在这个 Garbhodaksha Yang 上面有三个世界，而下面就是 Garbhodaksha Yang， 它这个地狱星球在三个世界和 Garbhodaksha Yang 之间。
Right, the three worlds above. You have the heavenly planets, the earthly planets, and the hellish planets.
我们听到有天堂星球、地球的这个星球，然后还有地狱的这个星。
Actually, the Sanskrit names are Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, and Swarga. Swargaloka. Swargaloka is the heavenly planets. Bhuvarloka is intermediate, and then Bhuloka, that's where we are. We're in Bhuloka.
We are in Bhuloka, and then there are Bhuvarloka, and Swarloka, these three loka. We are in Bhuloka.
And below that, you've got the...You've got the hellish planets.
而在布洛卡下面是地狱星球。
And Pitri Loka is also in this region between the Garbhodak Ocean and the lower planetary systems.
Pitri Loka 也处于 Garbhodaksha Yang 和低等的星系之间的这一片地方。
Pitri Loka means the planet of the forefathers.
Pitri Loka 是四位祖先所居住的地方。
And all the residents, all the people who live there in Pitri Loka, they all meditate on the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
所有 Pitri Loka 上面的居民，他们都在冥想着至尊人格守身。
And they also pray for their family's well-being as well.
他们也在那里为他们的家人。祈求祝福。
So from our planet going down, there are seven planet different set levels of planets.
在我们的星系，就是我们这个地球星系下面是有七个低等的星系的。
And the lowest is Patala Loka.
最下面的那一个星系叫做 Patala Loka.
And then below Patala Loka, that's the hellish planets.
而在这个 Patala Loka 下面就是地狱星球。
And then at the bottom of the universe is the Garbhodak Ocean.
在宇宙的底部是 Garbhodaksha 之洋。
So the hellish planets are between the Garbhodak Ocean and the Patala Loka.
因此这个地狱星球就位于 Patala Loka 和 Garbhodaksha 洋之间。
And the king of the Pitas,The king of the Pita, the king of the Pitri Loka is Yamaraj.
Pitri Loka 的国王是 Yamaraj.
And he's very powerful. He's the son of the sun god.
他非常有力量，他是太阳神的儿子。
And he lives at Pitri Loka with all of his assistants.
他和他的这些助手们都住在 Pitri Loka.
And he follows all the rules and regulations made by the Supreme Lord.
他遵守着至尊主制定的所有的这些规范原则。
And he has his servants, the Yamaduras, they bring all the sinful people to him when they die. When the sinful people die, the Yamaduras bring them to Yamaraj.
而他的那些仆人助手 Yamaduta 在那些所有的罪恶的人一死了之后，这些亚玛都塔就会把这些死亡的人带到亚玛拉吉面前。
So Yamaraj will hear about what they've done, about their sinful activities, and then he will decide what place they should go, where they're punished, what kind of punishment they should get.
然后亚玛拉就会聆听关于这些人他们所从事的罪恶活动。然后根据他的罪恶活动去审判他到底该去这些地狱星球中的哪一个地方。
So some people, they don't believe in hell, but it's described here in the scriptures.
有一些人是不相信有地狱的，但是在这个经典里描述了这样的情况。
And some people don't believe there's a Yamaraj, but he's described here. He's very, very real. He's a person.
有一些人也不相信有 Yamaraj 的存在，但是他是真实的，他也在这里被描述，他是真实的。
He's given the position of the God of death by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, put him in that position to make sure people follow the rules and regulations. We have to understand what is karma and what is vikarma and what is akarma. So conditioned souls, they come to the material world for sense gratification. So they're allowed to enjoy, but only under certain rules and regulations. If they don't follow the rules and regulations, then they get punished by Yamaraj. And the purpose of the punishment is to bring them back to Krishna consciousness. But Maya is so powerful that even after they're punished, they still want to do sinful activities. They still live in material condition and they commit sinful activities again and again. So some people say that there's 21 hellish planets, but other people say there's 28 different hellish places. So all of these different planets are meant for punishing the living, the sinful people, the sinful living entities. So Sukadeva Goswami is going to describe to us about some of these different planets. He says, anybody who takes another's wife or money or children, then at the time of death, the Yamaduras will bring him for punishment. So this person, he's put into this planet, a planet called Tamishra, which is very dark planet. So the Yamaduras, they beat him and they starve him and they don't give him any water to drink. So the servants of Yamaraj, they give a lot of pain and suffering to this person and he will faint due to their beating, due to their punishment. And if somebody is very cunning and cheats another man and enjoys another man's wife or children, then his punishment is to, he's like a tree which is being chopped at its roots. The man suffers so much that he loses all of his intelligence and he cannot see anything anymore. So he's put in the planet called Andhatamishra, Andha means blind, a place of blind and blindness and misery. The next kind of hell is described. It's a person who he thinks he is a body and he works very hard all day and night just to get money.
下面一种情况就是他认为这个躯体就是我，然后他非常努力的工作维系家庭。
Yeah, he works to get the money, he thinks, for his to maintain his body and to give to his wife and for his children. He would just work all the time. And he will often be violent against other living entities. So at the time of death, he suffers the reactions for his envy. If somebody thinks they're the body, then they're described in the scriptures to be no better than a cow or an ass.
经典上描述，一个人如果认为他是躯体的话，他只不过是一头驴或者母牛。
If somebody thinks they're the body made up of three elements, like mucus, bile, and air, then they're like an animal.
这样的人，他认为他的躯体，他认为他只是由胆汁、粘液和空气组成的一个皮囊而已。
Or he thinks that the land in which he's born in is worshipable.
或者他认为他的土地是很值得崇拜的。
Or he takes bath in the holy water at the holy place, but never takes advantage of the people who are in knowledge who live there.
这样的人也许会去朝圣之地的这些圣河去沐浴，但是他从来不利用那些真正处于知识之中的人。
But he's very attached to his wife and his children.
他非常依附于他的妻子和他的孩子。
So this person is no better than the cow or than us.
所以这样的人比母牛或者驴，并没有比他们强。
So there's two kinds of classes. There's two levels of being like an animal described here.
有两类人，他们非常专注于物质化的躯体的生命概念。
The first person thinks he is a body. He thinks the body is himself. So he's like an animal.
第一类人，他是这个躯体，就是自我，因此他就像动物一样。
But the second person, he not only thinks he's the body, but he also does all kinds of sinful activities to maintain his body.
第二种情况的人，他不仅把自己的这个躯体认为是自我，他还从事很多的罪恶活动。
He cheats everyone to get money for his family.
他欺骗很多人，去为了家人，为了自己和家人去谋取这些钱财。
And he's envious of people, other people, without any good reason. So if a person thinks his body to be, if he thinks he is a body, then he's very sinful. He's like the animals. The animals also think like that.
如果一个人认为他只是一个躯体的，只是这个躯体的话。 他就像动物一样，因为动物也是这么在思考的。
But if one commits sins to maintain the body, then he's more sinful.
前面的一个人是很罪恶的，但是如果一个人，而且他不仅认为这个躯体就是我，他还为了维持这个躯体去犯罪的话，那他就更罪恶了。
The animals are in the bodily concept of life, but they do not do sins to anybody.
一个动物，它处在动物的躯体之中，但是它不会从事罪恶活动。
Animals, they just eat and sleep and mate and defend. They don't worry about other people.
动物它吃、睡、防卫和交配，但是它不会去考虑其他的人。
So the animals, they don't go to hell.
但是动物它不会去到地狱。
But when a human being, when he's cheating people, when he's envious of others, then he's very sinful and he goes to hell. He goes to hell.
但是如果一个人为了维持自己而去欺骗、嫉妒他人的话，从事罪恶的活动的话，他就会被投进到地狱的处境。
So after his death, he's taken to this hell by Yamaraj.
在他死后，Yamaraj就会把他带到地狱。
And all the different people and animals which he hurt, they all come in the form of a very fierce animal to give him pain and to make him suffer, because he gave them suffering. So these animals come to give him suffering, to give it back to him.
他被带到地狱的时候，那些曾经被他伤害的那些生物，就会以一个非常可怕的形体给他带来很剧烈的痛苦。
And these animals, they're more envious, they're very ferocious and nasty, and they're worse than snakes.
而这个动物它非常的可怕，而且非常的嫉妒，比蛇更加的嫉妒。
And they come just to give this person trouble because he gave them trouble. So they come to pay back the suffering they got from him.
而这个动物来就是为了给这个人带来他的果报反应，因为他在之前的时候伤害了其他的动物，给他其他的生物造成的痛苦。
So people who give pain and suffering to others, they have to go to this hellish planet. They have to suffer.
因此，那些给其他生物带来痛苦的人，他也必须被投入到地狱星球之中，他也必须遭受痛苦。
And these animals will come and they'll eat his flesh and they'll give him a lot of suffering.
而这个动物就会来吃掉他的血肉，让他造成很巨大的痛苦。
So to maintain their bodies and satisfy their tongues, some people, cruel people, will cook animals and birds.
为了维系这个躯体，满足这个舌头，有一些非常残酷的人，他就会烹饪动物。Sometimes
they will cook the animals and birds while they're still alive.
有一些人烹饪动物的时候，甚至这些动物都还是活着的，动物和鸟类。So
these people are, they're very sinful. In the next life, they're taken by Yamaraj, and they're cooked in boiling oil.
因此，这些罪恶的人，他在死后也会被Yamaraj带走，他会被放到沸腾的油里面去烹煮。Yeah,
there's a special hellish planet where these people are cooked alive in boiling oil.
有一个很特别的星球，就是为那些去烹饪那些动物的人准备的。And
if somebody kills a Brahmana, then he goes to a special hell, a hellish planet, where the entire surface of the planet is made of copper, and it's very, very hot.
如果一个人他杀害一个婆罗门的话，他会被投进到一个地狱，而这个地狱它由全部由铜制成，这个铜非常的热。
Right, the copper is heated below. There's a fire below which heats the copper, makes it very hot. And above the copper, there's the very hot sun.
这个地狱的星球由铜制成，它的下面被火烧着，上面又被太阳给炙烤着。
So the person who murders a Brahmana, he's put there, and he has to, he just doesn't know where to go. Everything is burning hot.
杀害婆罗门的话，他会被投入到这样的地方。地方他完全不知道从哪里逃走，因为每一个地方都很烫。
He's burning. He's very hungry and he's very thirsty. There's nothing to eat. There's no water. Nothing. And he's just burning from the heat.
这个地方也没有吃的，也没有喝的，他总是被燃烧着，而且非常非常的热，到处都灼烧着，让他到处跑。
Sometimes he runs, sometimes he stands, sometimes he even lies down or sits down. He cannot find any place where there's no suffering. It's all suffering. And as many as there are hairs on the body of the animal, he has to live for as many thousands of years. In this place.
那个动物身上的毛发有多少多少，它就得在那里遭受多少的苦，因此它得在那里遭受成千上万的年头。
We can see how much suffering there is in this hellish planet.
我们可以看它在那里得遭受多么大的痛苦。
So sometimes also a person.They don't follow the Vedas, they don't follow the rules and regulations. So they're also, and they don't have a good reason for not following, they just because they're lazy, they didn't want to follow the rules and regulations. So they also go to hell.
有一些人他不遵循伟达经，但是他也没有什么理由不遵守这个伟达经，也不是说特别好理由，他就是懒惰不想遵守这个伟达经。因此他也会被投入到这个地狱。
And the servants of Yamaraj, they beat him with whips, and the person screaming and running from trying to save himself is in so much pain, suffering.
而 Yamaraj 的仆人就会用鞭子抽打他，他到处跑。
And there are these trees, palm trees,But the leaves on the palm trees are like sharpened swords. So when he runs into the trees, he gets cut to pieces.
而这个星球上还有很多的棕榈树，这个棕榈树上的叶子就像利剑，就像剑一样。当他被抽打，然后到处跑的时候，他跑到那个树上，然后又被树割得遍体鳞伤。
So he's screaming, what should I do? How can I be saved? Help me.
然后他就哭喊道，我现在该怎么办？我要怎么样才能得到拯救？请救救我。
So when people don't follow the religious principles properly, they know what the religious principles are, but they don't follow them, they suffer like this.
因此，如果一个人他并不遵循这些宗教的规范原则的话，他就会遭受这样的痛苦。
So, that actually the rule is to follow the instructions of the Supreme Lord. But in this Kali Yuga, people are all atheists.
事实上，唯一的宗教原则就是遵循至尊人格守神的命令。而但是很不幸的是，在这个卡利年代。每一个人都是无神论者。
They don't believe in God, so they don't believe. They don't believe His words. When we tell them what Krishna says, they don't believe.
因他们就不相信有神，因为他们不相信有神，所以他们也不相信神所说的话。
In the past, there was only one process, one set of religious principles.But now there are many.
在过去的时候，只有一套系统，一套宗教原则。但是现在有很多的宗教原则。
So, whatever he does, he should follow the principle strictly. Whichever ones he accepts, he should follow strictly. But people are all atheists. They don't follow anything.
也就是说。无论他做什么，他应该非常严格地遵循这些宗教的规范原则。但是由于现在人们都是无神论者。
If somebody takes a different process, if he goes to a different process, then he should follow the principles of that process. He might be a Christian, he might be a Muslim, he might be a Hindu, but he should follow the principles of that religion. So if somebody makes their own path, if they use their own, by their mind, they make a path of their own, then he's punished in hell.
然而，如果一个人他根据自己的心意去捏造一个自己的宗教的道路的话，他就会被投入到地狱之中受惩罚。
And if one doesn't follow anything, you don't believe in anything, then you also get punished.
如果一个人他什么都不遵循的话，他也会被遭受惩罚。
So everybody should follow some system of religion.
因此，每一个人都应该至少遵循。
If he doesn't follow any religious process, then he's just like an animal. So, we know as Kali Yuga goes on, people will become more and more atheistic, and there'll be no more God, no more religion.
越来越往前走的时候，人们越来越处于无神论的这个状态，越来越不信神。
So they should know that there's a punishment awaiting for them. They have to go to this hellish planet and be punished.
他们应该知道，确实一定会有惩罚在等着他们，有地狱星球会去惩罚他。Then
Sukadeva Goswami mentions, he said, somebody may be a king, or he may be a government representative, and if they punish an innocent person, then they will also go to hell.
Sukadeva Goswami 也描述到，如果一位国王或者一位政府的代表，他惩罚了一个很无辜的人，他也会被地狱。
And if they punish. If they try to put punishment on a brahmana, like physical punishment on a brahmana, then that's also very sinful, and they have to go to hell for that. And that sinful person, when he goes to Yamaloka, then he is crushed. He's put through a machine. He's put through that machine, just like they crush sugar cane. Squeeze out the juice, so they put the living entities through that machine and they crush them.
对于这样的人，他去到那里的时候 ，Yamaraja 这些有力量的助手就会像榨甘蔗汁一样把它给榨了。So
the person suffers a lot and he faints and he cries out, suffering.
这个人就会遭受很大的痛苦。
So this is what happens when they punish a person who is not actually guilty, didn't do anything wrong, but they punish the wrong person. This is the reaction they get. So you can see it's very dangerous to be a king or to be a government representative, to take a responsible position, is very dangerous. You have to get these sinful reactions if you punish an innocent person.
如果他们惩罚的那些很无辜的人，他们就会有罪恶的报应。We
know Yamaraj even got cursed.
我们知道，即便 Yamaraj 他也遭受了诅咒。Because
somebody who wasn't sinful got in trouble, So he blamed Yamaraj, and Yamaraj was cursed to become a Sudra. But for Yamaraj, that was good to be cursed. Because now he thought he could, now he's free, he can go and visit the holy places and he can associate with all the holy men living in the holy places. All the time as Yamaraj, he was only meeting the sinful people. But when he got cursed to become a Sudra, he got a chance to associate with nice devotees. So he was very happy to get away from his service of being Yamaraj. So now, next, Sukadeva Goswami describes how there are little insects like bugs and mosquitoes which take the blood of human beings and other animals.
Sukadeva Goswami 下面将会我们描述这些虫子、蚊子之类的低等的生物体，它们吸人类的动物和其他动物的鲜血。
So these insects, they don't know that their bites are painful to the human beings. They don't know that.
这些动物，他们根本就没有意识到他们在咬别人的，在叮咬他人的时候，给别人带来的痛苦。But
people like Brahmanas and Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, they have a higher consciousness and they know how painful it is to be killed.
但是这些一流的比较高阶层的人，比如说 Brahmana, Kshatriya 和 Vaishya，他们是能体谅到，当一个人被杀的时候是有多大的痛苦的。So
if a human being, if he kills innocent creatures, then it's sinful.
因此，如果一个人有知识的人杀了这样的生物的话，他是罪恶的。
And the Supreme Lord will punish that person, putting them into a special hell. And in that hell, all the birds and the beasts and the insects and everything, they will all come and they will bite him and attack him and give him so much suffering.
虫子、蚊子就又会来攻击这个人，咬这个人。
They attack him all the time. He can never sleep. He tries to sleep, but these things will come and they'll bite him and disturb him.
这个人就会被无休止的攻击，一直遭到这些动物、蚊子等等这些生物体的攻击，而这个人遭受的攻就一直遭受攻击，他根本没法睡觉。
So this is the suffering which is put on a person for killing innocent creatures.
这就是对于一个惩罚这样的微不足道的这些生物的这些人的罪恶，对他们的这个惩罚。But
we can understand that the little insects and the little creatures which disturb us, they don't get punished.
我们也得了解。 这些动物就是打扰我们的蚊子啊、昆虫啊，它们虽然在咬我们，但是它们不受到惩罚。But
we get punished because we know about what's we know about the pain of being killed.
我们会被受到惩罚，是因为我们知道杀害的时候是有多么大的痛苦。So.
Everybody has to act according to their position, either in a Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they should act according to their duty.
婆罗门也好，叉车也好，歪舍书者也好，他们都得根据自己的职责规范原则去活动。
And one of the duties, one of the things they should do is they shouldn't trouble any innocent animal or any innocent creature like insects.
而他们的一个原则就是永远不要去给动物制造麻烦，或者给那些打扰人类的动物制造麻烦。
So even a tiger is not sinful if he attacks another animal and eats his flesh.
一只老虎如果去攻击其他的动物，吃它的肉，它是没有罪的，这个老虎是无罪的。
But if a man kills an animal, he will get punished.
如果一个人去杀害动物的话，他会被受到惩罚。
So anybody in the human body who acts like an animal, they get punished in different kinds of hell.
如果一个有人类躯体的人，一个生物，他活得像动物一样的去行为的话，他会被受到惩罚。
And that, then another type of hell is if somebody gets some food and he does not share it with guests, he doesn't give it to the guests, he doesn't feed the children or the old man, he simply eats it himself, then that's sinful.
如果一个人得到了一些食物，但是他却不分给他的客人、老人还有孩子的话，只是独自享用的话，他也是罪恶的。
He's no better than a crow. A crow is like that. He gets food, he just wants to eat it himself. And whatever food one gets, one's meant to offer it first in sacrifice. There's sacrifices supposed to be done before we eat food. So if you don't give your food, if you don't share your food, then you're put into this hell, and you're put into a big lake which is filled with worms, and it becomes a worm in that lake.
这样的一个吝啬的人，他得到东西就是不分给他们，不分给其他人的人，吃独食的人，他死后会被投到一个地狱，这个地狱有一个湖，里面全部都是虫子。
And these the worm in the lake, they eat the other worms, and the worms will also eat him.
这个湖里面的一只虫子，它以吃其他的虫子为食，它的这些虫子也就会来吃它。
So if he doesn't make any atonement, if he doesn't do anything to purify himself before death, he's put into that lake to be a worm there, and he'll stay there for many years, for many thousands of years.
因此，这样的一个人，除非在临死之前为自己的行为忏悔，否则他在死后就会被投入到这个。星球在这个湖里面待上很多很多的年，遭受可怕的惩罚。
So we should understand whatever food we get is given to us by the grace of the Lord.
我们得了解到所有的食物都是由至尊人格守神赐予给我们的。
So he should acknowledge that it's given by the Lord by performing yagya. You have to offer the food and sacrifice.
因此我们应该举行祭祀来答谢他的仁慈。
If we don't do sacrifice, then we get caught in the material nature, the reactions of work.
如果我们不做祭祀的话，我们就会被因为这种反应而被关在这个物质世界。
So we should do the yagya, and then we should distribute prasadam to others, and then our life becomes purified.
因此我们要做祭祀，然后把食物派发给就把菩萨等派发给他们，这样我们就会有好的。
And people who have dependents, if you have children, or if you have some brahmanas, or some old men, then you should feed them first. You should not eat before them.
如果我们身边还有我们有有孩子、有婆罗门、有老人的话，在派发食物的时候，我们应该先派发给他们，应该让他们先吃，我们才可以再吃。
But if we just cook for ourselves, just eat ourselves, then this is not good. This will take us to hell.
如果我们只是一个人吃，只是给我们自己做的话，我们会被投入到地狱之中。
Then somebody may cheat a brahmana. They may rob him. They may take some of his wealth. So then that's also very sinful, and one goes to hell.
如果有人欺骗一位婆罗门，或者说抢劫一个婆罗门的话，这也是很罪恶的行为，他会被投入到地狱之中。
And in that hell, his body, entire body, is cut to pieces.
在那个地狱里，他的躯体会被切成一半一半的。
And his skin is ripped off his body by red hot iron tongs.
他的皮肤会被炽热的铁球和铁钳子给撕开。
Then the next type of hell is where people do illicit sex.
另外一个地狱星球是为了一些沉迷于性交的人准备的，就是非法性交的人准备的。
The man and the woman are beaten with whips.
男人和女人会被鞭打。
And the man, he has to embrace a red hot form of a woman made out of iron. He has to embrace this red hot form.
这个男人就会被。而且会被被迫拥抱一个炽热的铁铸成的一个 女人的形象。
And the woman has to embrace a similar form of a man. She has to embrace the red hot form of a man.
这个女人也会被迫拥抱一个由炽热的铁块铸成的男人的形象。
So this is the punishment for illicit sex.
这就是对非法性行为的惩罚。
So the rule is one should only have sex with one's wife, according to Vedic principles, only with your legal wife.
根据伟达的规范，伟达的原则，一个男人只应该和自己的妻子发生性关系。
But if you have a relationship with another man's wife, then that other man's wife is actually like her mother in the Vedic culture.
如果一个男人和其他的女人发其他的妻子发生关系的话
，and it's very sin.
其他人的妻子应该被视为是自己的母亲。
It's very sinful to have sex with one's mother or sister or daughter.
和自己的母亲、姐妹和女儿发生性关系是非常罪恶的行为。
So this puts a person into hell and causes them to suffer for a long time.
这就会让他去到地狱，然后在那里遭受很长时间的惩罚。
And if it's a woman, if the woman has sex with a man other than her husband, then this is like having sex with her father or her son.
如果一个女子和其他的男人性行为的话，他另外这个男子会被应该被认为是他的儿子或者说是他的父亲。
So people are always punished for these things.
人这样的一些人就会被受到惩罚。
And there's a hell if somebody has sex with even animals, then he's put into a very bad hell also.There's a special hell where he goes.
如果有一些人他甚至和动物性交的话，他甚至更糟糕，也会被投入到更糟糕的地狱星球之中。
And then in that hell, there's a special tree which is full of thorns, and it rips a person to pieces.
在那个地狱里有一棵非常特别的树，叫丝光木棉树，它有非常多的这个尖刺。把他弄得一刺这个人。
Yeah, and the Yamaduras, they hang that sinful man, they hang him on the tree, and they pull him down so that all the thorns will cut his body to pieces.
Yamaraj 就把这个代理人就会把这个人吊在这样的长满刺的这个树上，然后用力往把它往下拽，让这个树上的刺全部刺穿这个人的身体。
So people are so sometimes so mad for sex that they will do these crazy things.
有一些人非常的疯狂，想去做这些很疯狂的事情。
So there's this special hell to where they're punished.
这是有因此有一个有特别的这个星球地狱星球去惩罚他们。
So Krishna consciousness is. In Krishna consciousness movement, we do not allow anyone to have illicit sex.
Krishna 知觉的运动严禁任何人发生非法性行为。
So sometimes people they don't believe these descriptions, but
有些人他们,
but whether they believe or not, everyone should be they should be very careful what they do.
无论他们是信还有一些人他不相信这些地狱的描述，但是无论他们信还是不信，他们都无法避免他们最后的这个遭受的结果。
No one can avoid the laws of nature.
没有人可以避免自然大自然的法律。
Okay, we'll stop here today.
好，我们今天讲到这。
Hare Krishna.
今天也有几个问题提上来，我们留到下次课再回答吗？
Nijadana.
因为还有一些人在线等。真的。
Okay, well, moment
run me. 今天我们讲课部分就到这里好吗？好。 接下来，因为我们还有很多奔现者在二号那天没有跟您通话，所以今天他们都等待，想得到您的仁慈的联谊。
哦，OK。
所以那接下来我们就按照我们已经申请通话的这个。